Good morning. Welcome to the Ward Scott Files, News Radio 980 and live on the internet, newsradio.com, wardscottfiles.com. Yeah, there was a special meeting of the county commission at 1:30 in the afternoon, ran about 3 hours, and about 2 hours and 45 minutes, something like that, into it. You hear some amazing conversation by Hutchinson about penalizing deputies for arresting people for pot, which, and we're going to play this extensively in the second hour and talk about this. But Ed has not heard this. Ed was not aware of this as the mayor of Gainesville. Ed, we're going to give you a special screening. Go ahead. Have you got it set up, James?
Okay. Well, I thought it could be handled just by talking nice to the sheriff. And so I did that the first year. Second year, did the little budget adjustment based on the fact that she was uncooperative. I don't know what I'm going to do this third year in the budget, but it's got to be something. Because what I really want is the deputies to hear, sorry you didn't get your raise because you're busting people.
I don't think it's got to
stop at the street level. They got to quit busting people.
Well, there you are. We're going to run that a little bit more. And Ed has not heard that. He could not
that
even imagine that kind of conversation. Now, that is your county commissioner.
Okay? My gosh.
Verbally, out loud, in a meeting of a public meeting, getting ready to go after the deputies on the street for doing their job. Now, you tell me what Black-on-Black Crime Task Force told you guys.
Well, I mean, the Black-on-Black Crime Task Force was really started many years ago. It's been going on and has great participation, and it's concerned largely with the behavior of youth, and some of the crimes that take place, in an effort to, one, get kids channeled in the right direction, young men in particular channeled right direction, and to make community safer. And so, and I don't have the data right in front of me, but I can just say, I can say factually that when you see arrests made in, predominantly minority neighborhoods, what are called minority-majority neighborhoods, the calls that go to police that result in the arrest, the calls originate from that neighborhood, from the Black neighborhoods themselves. And so it's from people who want their neighborhood to be safer. And so the idea that the deputies are just sort of rolling through neighborhoods looking for young folks to arrest is really, I think, out of line. Well, one, it's not substantiated by the facts, and two, it's really out of line to threaten their pay, essentially, or an increment in their pay based on that. And it's pretty shocking.
Okay. Well, I thought it could be handled just by talking nice to the sheriff. So I did that the first year. Second year, did the little budget adjustment based on the fact that she was uncooperative. I don't know what I'm going to do this third year in the budget, but it's got to be something. Because what I really want is the deputies to hear, sorry you didn't get your raise because you're busting people.
It's got to
stop at the street level. They got to quit busting people.
I should have studied code.
Last thing I have, Hutch, you mentioned last night when you were talking about solving this problem of different topic now of prosecutor and police chief doing four things to change the religious change, getting folks put into the criminal justice system. You said not arresting minors, not arresting.
No. The deal is in Amsterdam, the chief prosecutor and the police chief said, if you comply with these four things, we won't bust you. No sales to minors, no public nuisance, no advertising, and nothing over 5 grams.
No public
nuisance. Okay. So where are you going with this?
Well,
the sheriff right now has the power.
I understand. Where are you going with it? Because you keep bringing it up, but it's not
I keep leveraging. Yeah, I can't ask a question, but I keep trying to figure out why we just don't do that.
You want to pursue it in your capacity as a county commissioner, so I'm asking.
Yeah, I continue to pursue it. I continue to raise hell in my own little subtle ways about it. And I think it's important to set ourselves apart from places that continue to bust kids for small amounts of dope that ruins their lives. I mean, that's just nuts.
Well, here's another commissioner that's interested in doing that with you. I have two articles I want to just give to everyone. That conversation prompted me to make copies of them.
You gave it to
him. No, I didn't give you this. Did I give
you? I got a copy.
You got these? Oh, the toy I gave
some
to
of
you.
That stuff,
okay,
right.
All right, good. Oh, that's
way
it.
To heal some darn tree.
I'll reach out to them.
I'm three commissioners who want to do that. I've been trying to do it for 15 years. So if there's traction now for three people to do it, the key is how? What's the mechanism?
How do you do that?
I was hoping you would follow through on your marijuana questioning thing.
First thing I would do is take control of the jail and simply not allow anybody to be put in jail that's been busted on pot. Sorry, that's not a charge we allow people in this jail for.
Either. That's probably not legal.
I don't think you can probably do that.
We can definitely take charge of the jail. Law enforcement officer arrests someone and brings them to the jail, I'd be extremely surprised if we could turn them away.
Yeah. No, not gonna be able to do that.
We might have policies in place and turn them right back out the door. I don't know, but that seems sketchy to me.
Well, there's a lot of little mechanisms that can be brought to bear that
perhaps this is a discussion that we should have with the state's attorney's office.
Well, that's what I have.
Talked with all of them for hours, and if you want to have that same set of conversation, it's very interesting because the courts don't want these people in the courts. The problem is it's the definition of booking. Once somebody's booked, then they no longer are under the jurisdiction of the sheriff, they're under the jurisdiction of the courts. Every decision has to be made, and then the prosecutor has to get involved because the judge won't make a decision without hearing from the prosecutor and the defense attorney. So it starts this whole process going the moment the cop decides to arrest him. And what I was trying to do, I was hoping we would be, the police would be understanding enough, is that every time they arrest somebody, that's their raise that went out the door, because if you tie their raises to the cost of all of us, then they would quit doing it.
Well, what if we had a conversation with the city of Gainesville and Russ and the police chief? And
listen, y'all, can I please interject here, because the perfect mechanism for this discussion already exists, perfect vehicle. Are you familiar yet with the Public Safety Coordinating Committee?
No.
Who's the current liaison? You are? Okay, I sat on the thing for years and pursued this in that vehicle. It is the perfect way to have this discussion. Have you sat on it yet?
Yeah.
You've never sat? You need to get on there. Leah, do you go to the meetings?
Yeah.
You're active?
Yeah.
Okay. We should all get on there at one point or another. The Public Safety Coordinating Committee, enabled by, are you the legal staff to that these days? Who is? County
Sounds
staff?
Like Bill Harlan.
Okay. It was.
I don't think I remember seeing it. One of y'all in there.
Okay, then I don't know.
It's state enabled to have these things set up. The purpose of the Public Safety Coordinating Committee is to control jail population through alternative means. It is all the agencies you've mentioned and more.
Yeah.
It's the public defender, it's the state attorney, it's the judiciary, it's the county, it's the city, it's GPD, it's the Alachua County Sheriff's Office, it's High Springs, it's everyone who has, it used to be Waldo, not anymore, but everyone who has a police department. All the big player social service agencies, and they get together and they discuss they start the meetings by looking at the jail population. And they track it each month.
Last one lasted about 7 minutes, 5 minutes.
And they talk about that, what's happening, why. How can we reduce the population?
Who's in charge of that?
And I've had
chief judge.
And I sat on it for like 5 years in a row. And every time I brought up the discussion, it was the kind of response Hutch is describing. Everyone in the room agreed, yes, this is a good idea. We agree we should try to do something about getting people with minor drug offenses, out of the jail, either don't take them there at all or try to reduce their exposure to the judiciary. And then everyone ends up looking at each other, how do we do it? There's 15 different moving parts, and there's a lack of consensus and drive in that group to make it happen. That's the vehicle. If you really want something to happen, the players are at the table.
Why don't you come to the next meeting?
I've always had it on my schedule, and it seems like that.
I mean, not come to present.
Yeah,
your
it's
idea.
Something that always conflicts.
Well,
I'll try to get there. It's on my schedule.
Why don't you ask me on the agenda?
See, I'm with the same group of people on the Seizure Side Committee. Essentially, we have judges, we have cops.
Smaller group though.
Season Sack's 15 people.
Smaller group. Although the attendance for this thing, there were a lot of...
But what it takes is it takes law enforcement to understand that they just don't need to bust these people.
I think they do, but they're in their silo.
Right.
They have instructions. This is how we have to do things. And they generally do, even though we all know some
of them. It's worse than they, you know, okay, we got to bust this kid. It's like they actively go out looking for pot with virtually every stop. And they still do. And I'm getting anecdotes, you know, I get an anecdote a week from somebody because of the high profile.
I don't know where you got your pot data, but the first time I charged up this hill, I did it through the Public Safety Coordinating Committee, and I asked for the same data, and I got a stack of undifferentiated data from, I think it was the prosecutor.
I went through Ted, what's his name?
McFetridge.
And I had one of his analysts spend a week sorting data, because it's not easily, you can't just press a button and it pops out.
Everyone complains about the lack of interusable data,
right,
and how hard it was to answer what I thought were some pretty simple questions.
I still got hundreds of pages of Excel spreadsheets that you have to
see. At some point it begins to sound like an excuse.
Right.
Because in this day and age, those kinds of firewalls between these coordinating agencies is just mysterious.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand there's a lot of confidential data involved, but asking them to be able to make data requests, if you can't answer a question like how many people were busted for each of the last 5 years for simple possession alone or as part of other misdemeanor offenses, which
right.
I think is the way I asked it.
Right.
It should take no more than a few days to pop that out. I never got an answer.
Baseball statistics, they can tell you how many times that he hit the ball when the sun was in his eyes and his shoelaces were untied. Bam, just like that.
I never got an answer. And
important
it took the sheriff
stuff,
months to come back with, you know, answers to your question. So if there's any hope, that's the vehicle, and it's the perfect vehicle.
And the chief judge would be the best person to his office, because they set the agenda.
Okay. Well, I thought it could be handled just by talking nice to the sheriff, so I did that the first year. Second year, we did the little budget adjustment based on the fact that she was uncooperative. I don't know what I'm going to do this third year in the budget, but it's got to be something. What I really want is the deputies to hear, sorry you didn't get your raise because you're busting people.
It's got to stop
at the street level. They got to quit busting people.
Yeah, I don't think it's fair to put it all on the deputies.
Not at all.
Yeah, I think it's a community-wide decision.
Perhaps a person shouldn't smoke down, you know, near anyway. But anyway.
Well, that may be true, but it's not really that.
I mean, it is against
the
law.
I mean, if this discussion can be driven from the prosecutor and the chief judge.
Well, it is in a sense because. Go sit in arraignments and first appearances where you're going to blow your mind, because the first thing that the judge I was in, he says, okay, you guys are going to get, you've heard me tell this story, there's a bunch of you in here for pot, you're going to hear a charge added, it's because we're going to drop the possession charge and convict you of paraphernalia because now you won't lose your driver's license. So here's a judge who, just to save time, because he's got so many of these things, that as a matter of course, and the prosecutor agrees and the defense attorney agrees, so all these people get up there and they plead guilty to paraphernalia, and they were all in there for pot, and a lot of them did 40 days in jail,
which is awful.
Well, I'll tell you, when I did it, I'm pretty sure I didn't have majority support on the county commission, and so it went no further than my participation at the PSCC. If you're going to go make a presentation and start this discussion again, I'll be happy to attend. And if you're happy to attend too, if that group sees a majority of the county commission indicate a willingness to change policy and move forward, it might change the tenor of the discussion.
Yeah, I just seems like we have no leverage whatsoever in any of this.
We do have leverage. We do have leverage.
And where would you see
where's the leverage?
The budget.
Okay.
You better believe it, because we deal with the consequences of these
right.
policies.
Okay,
not
so
only have the leverage,
gonna,
we have the right.
How are you going to do that?
I don't have that answer.
Well, I mean, we're about to go into budget hearings. This is the critical budget hearing where this is going to make a difference, because I've tried now kind of nicely for 2 years, and maybe it's saying we're going to close a jail pod or something like that. I mean, it's...
I don't even think it would take that much leverage. Again, I think all the players generally agree.
I played a lot of players this last year, I thought.
It would, well, okay. But the point is you got to have follow-through, and it will represent a large institutional shift. It's a lot of work. Bureaucracies don't like to do that, and they're inherently resistant to it, so it's going to take sustained leadership. I don't think people are not going to want to do it because they don't want to. It's just a lot of work.
Our ratio is 6-1 blacks to whites. I can't believe that, you know, the African American community is not storming the ramparts over that.
Well, they are. They elected us. And so I think to that point.
It's true. We all talk.
I am happy, you know, when the next meeting is, if you want to let us know, I am happy to join Commissioner Byerly. I am hopeful and I believe Commissioner Chestnut will join us and we'll all come with you. I think this is, for me at least, I mean, I talked about it with the sheriff for 20 minutes today. It's in our strat plan. This is important for me and why I was elected. And so I am happy to come with Commissioner Byerly, Commissioner Chestnut, and
all five of us showed up. I think it was we only have to do it once. I think that'd be a really powerful message. And ask them.
I want to do that.
How do we approach this problem?
And they say go talk to the legislature.
Okay. That's not an acceptable answer. We do have more discretion than we're using.
We have more. I agree. We have more discretion, more authority. And like I say, in Amsterdam, they just said this is our lowest priority.
We don't have that authority. We can't.
Well, obviously, it was the police chief and the prosecutor.
Right.
The two of them said, it's now our lowest priority. We're going to go catch everybody else first, every shoplifter, every wife beater, whatever, and not worry about the potheads.
Well, that'd be an interesting discussion.
Let us know, Commissioner Pinkerson.
Be happy to do so.
Okay.
But, Hutch, I would recommend strongly you get in touch with the chief judge and ask that you want to be on the agenda and what you want to talk about. You know, that's the way it'll get done. And then perhaps you guys
all read the story that they are having a hard time convicting anybody. If somebody asks for a jury trial, the juries are all hanging on this stuff. And then it's a mistrial, and they just throw it out. So if people are smart enough, and any of you listening on TV, ask for a jury trial, because there's not a jury in Alachua County that will convict you of small-time marijuana anymore.
But it still doesn't solve the problem. They were there for 40 days.
It's on their record,
and then they lost their job because they were there for 40 days. So that's that gets them off. But I mean, I'm more interested in on the front end.
Yeah, exactly.
Drink beer is legal.
That's all I have. Yes.
Just on to Commissioner Cornell's subject.
Sorry, I got one quick one.
The statement is definitely a place where this can happen. I mean, that's where the real work is happening nationwide. There is talk about another ballot initiative to legalize marijuana. And medical marijuana. Although some people are talking about a Colorado-style ballot measure, too. I don't think that's gaining the momentum that the other one is.
We heard about it last night.
Yeah. But if Alachua County were to handle distribution and cultivation, that could fix our road problem too. So mm-hmm. I just thought I'd
that'd be in our Parks Department.
That's right, exactly.